Hello, ladies and gents. What I'm gonna be building is a solar generator or a mobile solar system. And here, I actually drew the little diagram of what I'm gonna be doing. So this is a 12-volt system. Obviously, you see a 12-volt battery. Beep, beep. Then you have a 200-amp fuse, a 2200-watt inverter, and this is the continuous wattage. This is the rating, and you're gonna know why this is important later on. A fuse block, and this is where you're gonna be installing all your DC appliances. A solar controller. So I chose a 40 amp solar controller. And the reason why I did that is because eventually I want to upgrade my system. I currently have two panels of 100 watt each. So a 200 watt panel system. And I want to upgrade it to a 400 watt. So by having a 40 amp controller, I'm able to do this upgrade. Now I also want to upgrade my batteries and create my own little battery bank and increase the efficiency of my system. The next question is, how did you came up with the amperage for the breaker and the amperage for the fuse? Good question. Let me show you over here. For this portion over here, this breaker is actually protecting the solar controller. The solar controller is 40 amps. This is the rating, 40 amps. And we multiply by the 1.25 factor. And this will give us 50 amps. Kink, kink. Now we go here, 200 amp fuse. How we came up with that? Obviously we have a 2200 watt system. This is an inverter and this is the continuous wattage for this inverter. So the formula is as follows: continuous wattage, which is 2200 watts. And then we divide it by, this is a 12 volt system. We have a 12 volt battery. So this is a 12 volt system. We divide that, do that portion, and then we missing one more thing. We multiply this by, king, king, 1.25. And this gives us about 229 amps. Obviously, power divided by voltage give you amperage. So 229 amps. And we don't have a 229 amp fuse. So we go to the lowest one, 200 amps. So 200 amps, that's the fuse we're gonna use. The whole point of this portion over here is to protect the whole system, especially the inverter. This takes a lot of energy. So the whole point of these fuses is if something happens, these fuses will burn out first and no power will go into the system and destroy our devices. So we want to prevent that. And that's why we have fuses and breakers and all these safety things. And in that case, let's start building. So let's get to the fun part. So this is the Pelican case. Obviously, as you can see, voila, there's a lot of space in here. I have my battery. I'm gonna be putting this block here. Voila, battery, first step. My 40 amp solar controller. And I'm gonna be installing this somewhere around here. This is a pure sine wave inverter. So I'm gonna install it somewhere around here. The next thing is this is the fuse block. And I'm gonna be putting the link to all these items on the description, so don't worry. This light is gonna be somewhere around here. This is a cigarette lighter. This is our USB connection. So this I'm gonna be installing it somewhere around here. This is the 200 amp fuse, and this is the cover. So when you buy this from Amazon, you actually get two fuses. Make sure you remove the second fuse because you want this to operate at 200 amps. And this will go somewhere around here. Okay, so now for the installation. This came with a little template, which was pretty great. So I'm gonna use this template to just mark where the holes are gonna be at, and then I'm gonna be installing this.
So here.
So for now, I'm gonna be using some other type of screws, but eventually I'm gonna be using machine screws and everything's gonna be all watertight. So for the inverter, I'm gonna be removing the bottom plate and using the bottom plate as a guide. Now we can put this back. So now I'm going to be installing this light somewhere around here. So the light came with this template, which I'm going to be using to mark it. So right now I'm adding the receptacle, which will be connected to the AC part of the inverter. So here I'm going to be using a small piece of 12-2 Romex wire. So now it's time to install the fuse block. So I managed to buy some machine screws, some washers, and some nuts. And as you can see, I already installed these. One thing, make sure that whenever you install these and make any penetration, you add some of these silicone to the outer side to make sure that everything is watertight. So now I'm going to be connecting the GFI outlet into the inverter. So now I'm going to be installing the 200 amp fuse. This is the power on and off for the inverter. This has a little communication wire in which communicates with the inverter and turns this off and on remotely. These two connectors, they come from this kit. This is what you see on the RV. And these are where the solar panel wiring will go through. And I'm gonna be installing them right there. And I'm not gonna use this. So these are the wire for the solar panel. So I'm gonna be connecting the red one to the positive side. So the next wire that I'm going to be connecting is from the solar controller, from the positive side of the battery, to this breaker. And then I'm cutting another piece, which will go from the breaker to the fuse. So I had to run to the hardware store to get these connectors. So now I made the cuts and installed the connector to size. So I'm gonna be connecting the positive side of the inverter into the 200 amp fuse. And on the other end, I'm gonna connect this line and into the positive of the battery. So now I'm going to install the neutral, which is going to go from the fuse block to the battery. So now all the major components are wired up. Right now I'm going to start connecting things to the battery to just make sure that everything is working properly. So let's start with the positive first. Now I'm going to start wiring the neutral. It's actually working. The battery was depleted. It was at 7.4 and right now we see 11.4. So it's actually charging. So far I only have one single panel. I am going to be connecting the other panel, but right now I'm testing to make sure that everything is working. So the only thing I'm missing right here is the installation of this light into the switch and then into the fuse block. But after that, the whole setup is completed. So I want to go over on how to install the latching switch. It could be a bit confusing. The way that I want the latching switch to operate is that whenever you press a button and it's on the downside, the LED on the button itself is on and the light bulb turns on. In order to do that, this is what I did. The yellow wire is the common, gets connected to the positive side of the battery. Then the normally open gets spliced in with positive side of the LED and also get spliced in with the positive side of the LED of the button. So the neutral is pretty simple. Neutral, you run it straight to the battery, and the neutral for the light bulb, you run it straight to the battery. So this is how it's supposed to look. So the positive side, which is the red wire, goes to the positive side of the fuse block, which will be protected by the fuse to protect the whole circuitry. And the negative side goes to the negative side of the fuse block. Pretty simple. Oh, you're there. So, this is it.